third example is on what?
Null pointer exception. Let's this program as it is. Let's create another.
Is there any problem? Okay.
So can I create one more class, user defined class? Or can I write some class here like this, class student? If I write something like this, is there any problem?
I don't want to create a new class for the time being, new program.
Can I declare a member here? String name. Can I declare a member like this? Okay. Now tell me, can I create an object here? Yes. Now can I access this name? What kind of output is this? What kind of data it will return? String.
std.name is what? String.
So if it is a string, can I use dot length? Logically I can use. It's not compiler error. Logically can we use like this? So it will throw what? If you run the program, what will happen? Can you see the output? Null pointer exception. Hello. But sir, why you have created like this? Can't you simply declare a variable str and write str.length? Can't we create?
Can we create something like this? In this case, compiler will not allow you. Because in this case, str is what? It's a local variable. And in the local variable, the value is what? Garbage. So that's why the compiler itself doesn't allow you. It is throwing you an error. It will say you what? Str has never been initialized.
So that's why we have done like this. That's why I have taken a such example. Example of student.
That means we have created an object.
Okay, are you getting it? We have created an object. Or you can do what? If you do not want to do this, in fact you can remove this. What you can do? You can create an array of string. Can I create an array of object? String object. So in this case what we have to write? So what we have done? We have created an array. Array of string. So now what will happen if you try to access, since it is an object now, what will happen? All the values, all the index will get default value. And what will the default value? Null. It is a string here. Okay. So now if I try to access what? Str 0. I hope you people know how to manipulate array. What we are doing? This is the str reference variable and we are trying to access the zeroth position. What will be the value? Null. Since it is an object. So this is also a good example. So what is the value right now? Null. Or instead of that, can I write something like this? 0. This will become what? Null. So can I operate something like this? Can I write something like this?
Since it is a string, str 0 is what? String. Yes or no? Why? Because it is a type is what? String. So if I write str.length, what will happen? Null pointer exception.
Is there any doubt? Why?
Because the values we have not assigned. So this is an example of what? Null pointer exception.
So do you want to handle this block? Do you want to handle this program? Do you want to handle these exceptional use cases? Yes. So what you have to do? You have to make yourself familiar with the try. and you have to put all your logic where? In try. Why? Because this is your plan A. You want your program to be successfully executed. You don't want to go to the plan B or plan C. Plan B and plan C is something different. What is plan B? If any error comes, for any reason, who will handle this? Because we don't know. I don't know what kind of exception can come. I don't want to write too many catch blocks. So here, this is your plan. And here what we can do? Handle any exception. Let's see, it's working or not. So you have not used E. I'm not bound to use E. But yeah, I have detailed information of the exception available. Where? In this E. Who has created that? JVM. Let's debug the program. Debug as Java application. Where it will go? So that means it is able to handle. What we can see? Just go put a mouse to the E variable. It is showing what kind of exception? Null pointer exception. And this time, sir, there is no message. Okay, null pointer exception, there is no message also. Handle any exception. So I can show whatever the message I want to show to the end user. And here, again, you are getting the advantage. What is the meaning here? The meaning here is exception is equal to new null pointer exception. Ultimately, what is happening behind the scene? Behind the scene is happening what? Exception E. This is our catch block. But and this is the block that is created by whom? This has been created by whom? JVM. When it is executing line number 9. Sir, every time there is a problem on line number 9. No, it's not like that. You have some logic you have written over there. Is it clear? So now again you can do what? Sir, I want to handle the null pointer exception manually. Specifically. Not, we don't want to. This is a generalized block. Plan B is what? Generalized. I want to handle the null pointer exception in a special manner. So what we have to do? We have to create another catch block. Here what you can write? Null pointer exception. I am supposed to handle this. Okay, in this case, what will happen? Your line number 9, and who will handle this exception? Line number 12. Why? Because the type is null pointer exception. If this is not available, where it will go? Exception, parent. So parent now can. So exception is what? Exception is a generalized which can handle any exception. Let's run and debug one more time. After that we can discuss. Is it clear? So we have learned our basics of exception handling. And we have correlated it with what? Inheritance. We have correlated it with what? Polymorphism. We have correlated it with what? Upcasting. Okay? And still, upcasting. So in this case, sir, suppose if we have not written like this, if we have not written like this, and but the type of the object is what? But the type of object is? Null pointer exception. So what we can do? We can downcast. How to downcast? I hope so. You people have understood. I hope so. All is well. Okay? Is it clear? So if you don't want to put another specific block, still, and since this is a generalized block, what you can do? Null pointer exception. So let's do it. Debug the program, Java application. Okay, since we have not used it, so let's use it. Debug as Java application. Is it clear? It has been properly downcasted. But the point is, if suppose the exception type of the exception is not null pointer exception, what can happen here? There are chances what? The type. Right now we know the exception, the type of the exception is null pointer. So you have successfully done it. But if suppose the type of the exception is array index out of bound exception, what happens in this case? Now the error comes where? Inside your catch block. Getting the point? Now in fact that means your plan B also can throw some exception. So ideally how we downcast? We downcast like this. If E is an instance of, so this is a safety check. So whenever you are downcasting, you need to do what? By using what? By using instance of operator. Is it clear what is instance of? Why do we use instance of? For the safety check. And when the safety check is required, when this instance of operator is required in real world project, at the time of downcast. So you might be wondering when to use instance of operator. So we have learned in theory a lot of places, but where to apply instance of operator? At the time of downcasting. Ma'am, sir, now it's getting bouncer. I know that. So that's why we have recorded the session, so that you can revise it. Okay? Sorry for the bouncers. Okay? I'm not trying to put any bouncer, but at the same time, yeah. So let's at least debug the program one more time. What we are doing here? We are putting a safety check. What is the type of? And it has passed the safety check. In this case, our plan B will never throw an exception when we are downcasting it. Thank you very much for your kind patience and understanding what exception handling. You may also be interested in the, okay, this could also be an interesting one. Let's debug the program. Here we are doing what? Both trying to catch the exception, that means trying to handle the exception, plus throw the exception parallelly. Okay? We have handled this exception, and we have handled this exception in a specific manner by downcasting. And now here, what we are doing? Again, throwing the exception. Then who is going to handle this? JVM. So who is printing this to line? JVM. Okay, so did you understand throw and throws? If you want to throw, where we use throw? We use throw method, throw keyword within method. And where we use throws? Throws as the method signature label. We use throw keyword within method. That means with try, catch, finally, but where we use throws keyword, at least you can remember like this. If you cannot explain up to this to the interviewer, you can say that where we use throw keyword, we use throw keyword within method. That means when we are writing logic, while when we are handling the exception. And where we use the throws keyword as the method signature. The point number 6. Okay?